Good afternoon, everybody. Most of the asset management related slides, which I also want to cover, has been covered by my panelists. We all are in the same boat, faces the same challenges, whether it's access related or whether it's a cleaning schedule related issues, or any inverter failure is the major factor. Plus, one of the points which was covered is the grid quality, grid failure. So my presentation here basically is slightly different than what my co-panelist has presented. Okay, O&M is the thing, but how if it is, it was covered that initially if the design phase is taken care properly during the design, the O&M activity is simplified. Yes, that's true. So if you follow the best practices, or call it as ecosystem, creating an ecosystem for the maintenance team, then it will be ease for the actual workers or the laborers and the engineers who are there on the site, who has to climb the roofs. Mostly these ladders are monkey ladders, not easy to climb, height of 8 meters, 14 meters, so that's a height. So we, without frequently climbing up and down on those ladders, also is an issue. So if you have a proper system, make a preventive safety factors taken into consideration, then there will not be any hazards or accidents happening on the site. I would like to cover these aspects more in my presentation as in terms of O&M. First few slides about the organization. CleanMax is India's largest developer. We have almost 85 megawatt of the rooftop installations and 24% of the market share. Stands number one in terms of rooftop installations. We operate, maintain our system. It's on the mostly on the OPEX model. So investment is ours, and the unless and until we maintain it properly, the revenue will not come, and the lenders and the investor will not get the returns. That's already covered by Mr. Andrew also. So the PPA terms in the PPA has to be proper. What are the deemed generations? If the grid failure, how it is going to cover all those factors, and in no load is there on the Saturdays or Sundays or public holidays, how are you going to throttle your inverters? Or net metering is not always capped to consumption, is also these systems. If net metering is not there, then you have to throttle your generation because load availability of load is zero or very less. So on those conditions, how it is going to be, that it all needs to be covered in the PPAs. Yes, we have team of engineers, mostly most from IITians and from the industries, covered from all directions: engineer, civil, mechanical, electricals. We were awarded as the best from the National Excellence Award from MNRE. Some of the clientels, what CleanMax caters: food and beverage, IT, automotive, other manufacturing units and universities, government institutions, and many. The logos are self-explanatory. What are the best practices what CleanMax is following in terms of the rooftop installations? What we feel as a visual display. When a person, when always going as team is not the same, you train today one team, rooftop is the challenging thing. It's a turnaround time is very, very, very high in this industry. You train a person, after 6 months you find again the same safety training has to be given. You have to have the medical certification, entry permits. You have to go through the same cycle. That is the most hurdle. And if the same person is not there, then the new person, it takes time for him to adopt the new system because he has never worked on such an environment. So for adopting, and then it's bound to, because his work is to complete the model cleaning and the PM and just move ahead. He does not focus on the safety aspect. As you see in the last slide, the clientele base is very wide. So we have to follow mostly the safety norms. There are safety engineers, safety departments in all these industries. So unless and until you follow their safety norms, we are not permitted to work. So we feel that visual displays is a good reminder for the workers. So whether he is following the PPEs, whether he is following the safety norms, if not, he is forced to, his mental psychology also will force him to adopt those things. So that is one which will help engineers and the site team to implement the safety. The second challenge is the skylight we discussed. Skylights are the fragile sheet which are there for the natural lights in the industry. But that is the most hurdle in the O&M activity and the cleaning activity. Accident happens, it's not intentional. Person walks while cleaning or doing the maintenance, and the moment he steps on it, if the safety PPEs are not there, he is going to fall down and a major accident is going to happen. So all the skylight needs to be covered properly with the metal sheet, metal net, so that the light passes and the accident does not happen. Second is, while moving on the sloping roof, whether it's a RCC or the slope metal sheet, you need to have a safety lifeline installed so that person can hook his safety belts. Walkways, we are on the roof. Cleaning is, again, the frequency depends on the soiling losses, how much soiling it is, whether it's two times in a month or three times or four cycles. And when the person walks, frequent walking on the roofing sheet is going to damage the roofing sheet and the leakages may happen. So to avoid those, you have to install walkways all around wherever the walking movement is there. So that will protect the client's roof and also from the leakage of the rains or model cleaning water. As I mentioned, ladders climbing. We have carports and other super high structures either on the ground or on the roof. Then in such cases, we need to have safety ladders, a superstructure, carport, special lightweight movable ladders, because you have to move, you cannot have it one single location, with handrails and standing platform. Unless until the platform is there, the person cannot stand and do his cleaning. He has to use the mop, he has to spray the water. So those, his comfort level is also an important factor. If he is comfortable, then he will do an effective cleaning activity. As I said, monkey ladders. Once only monkey ladders, if the landing platform is not there, then it becomes difficult for him to stand and hook his lifeline to the lifeline, his harnesses. So once he stands on the platform, then he can easily hook his belt on the lifeline. Again, ladders normal. We have seen people use bamboo ladders or n number of type of thing which are not safe for a person to climb on the roof. With handrails, it makes easy, his life becomes easy. The next point what I would like to have is the proper inverter and SCDV protections. Here the protection is not only in terms of putting the fire buckets or fire extinguishers, but it also in terms of shade to prevent have a proper shade or a canopy on the inverter and the SCDVs. So when the person is on the roof working, the engineer, so he is also have his comfort level. Rubber mats are essential when it is ACDB or when someone you're doing the maintenance activity, it will prevent him from the shocks. Platforms, if it is ground mounted installation, then in front of the ACDBs you have a platform, so the operations height, eye level interaction is there with the equipments and the meters. Traceability, that's the real challenge. Because installations are done where you are not able to trace which inverter number one, what is the string, where it is connected, which part of my roof has that string. If ferrules are not there, whether it's a manual computer generated ferrules or other thing, so he has to trace it. Once the installation is done, tracing becomes very difficult. So proper identification in numbering system and the ferruling system has to be implemented, so the O&M work gets very is. So those are actually proper cable dressing. If dressing is done, then easy work happens. Cable laid in proper conduit, it is aesthetically also good, and maintenance wise also it is ease. Arrows, cable direction of the flow of current, whether it's going towards the ACDB or going cable out. So it instead of opening all the conduits and all the cable trays, you know, if I have to trace the DC incoming cable, then I only open those particular cable trays instead of then finding. The reason why I'm mentioning this, Today, as the manpower keeps on changing, the plant has to be maintained 25 years. Today's engineer will not be available after 2 years. Definitely. So the person who is new on the site, he also need to, he will not be trained, or he will not be aware about what was done 4 years down the line, or 3 years down the line, or 10 years down the line. So all these things will help him for his activity to carry out effectively. Earth pits, basically type, it should cover, the nameplate should cover what is the type of earthing electrode used, what is the purpose or the location of the earthing pit, what are the earth values, what was during the first installation when it was done, when is the next earthing to be carried out, what is the next due date, what is the when was it carried out also. Fall arrestors, we have already seen this part. Special tools, we basically use a special tools for module cleaning. So what are the, it's a brush with the water nozzle. Water is, scarcity of water is also an important factor. In the industries, you don't get ample water, or also it's a ground mounted any system. So effective utilization of water is an important aspect. So brush with a nozzle, where we can have less than 1 liter of per module water consumption. It can be lesser than that also, but currently we are able to achieve 1 liter. Expandable rod with is always, we see the matrix is not 2 by 2 modules or 3 modules. Sometimes it is 4 modules in a single row or 5 modules. So you need to, the person should reach to the last module on the when he's standing doing a module cleaning. So expandable things, rods is an important factor. When you're working on the modules, shock is electrical shock, any MC4 connector which is exposed may create an electric shock. So your rods should also have a protected from electric shock. So we use a carbon fiber cloth wounded brushes handles so that the safety is taken into consideration. Grass cutting, it's in the basically not on the rooftop, but it's on the ground mounted. When it is ground mounted, the vegetation control is one of the major factor. I'll just skip this thing. Lot of panelists has covered about the indigenous or the monitoring system, what exactly it does and how other things. So I will like to skip those things. We have same way monitors, more than 100 of parameters. The data which comes to the server is either 5 minute, 10 minutes or 15 minute cycle, depend on what type of your monitoring. We can monitor up to individual modules and the strings and the MPPT level. Auto alert, automated alerts and billing system is being implemented. That is standard operating practice for tracking of the site. This has also been covered, and drill down approach which has been specified at the same thing what I mentioned, SLAs, tickets are raised. Then it is the tickets have been issued to the individual engineer, and we can track how many, after how many hours the work has been completed, and those datas are used for the future analysis how we can avoid such situations. Some of the plant photographs, this is MIT Jaipur, Manipal University Jaipur, NBC Jaipur, GE Electric with the standing seam, carport at Nasik. This is Tata Nano plant in Sanand, Bangalore airports, Asai, Chennai. That's from my end. Thank you, sir.